各位傳媒朋友，首先在這裡很多謝選管會主席馮華法官為三位候選人作了一個非常之清楚的簡介會，讓這場選舉又進入了一個新的階段。在應該今晚開始，我們就會有機會是跟候選人是同台辯論，我希望在未來的兩三個禮拜都更加多這個機會，等到不但止1194位的選委和廣大的市民都可以從三位候選人的政綱裡面去多啲了解我哋嘅施政理念，同埋我哋提出嘅政策嘅措施。
同埋中央報告咧，第一次提到有關港獨問題啦，會唔會當選之後咧，為23條立法施加個壓力？
港獨嘅立場，我哋講得非常之清楚噶啦。香港係我哋中國不可分離嘅一部分，咁所以根本係完全冇空間喺香港咧去提出呢個港獨嘅議題。國家安全。在本地立法亦都是我們的憲制的責任，因為國家安全就等於是香港安全，香港安全亦都是我們700多萬市民那個人身的安全，所以必須要創造一個有利的條件，能夠讓這個本地立法工作可以展開。
民主三大家在初步決定捆綁投票給民望最高的一位候選人，你自己覺得在這個情況之下，你自己是否很舒適呢？還有你覺得他們的做法有沒有合適？
我只會在未來三個禮拜做好我自己作為一位候選人的工作，去爭取每一位的選委支持我成為下一任的行政長官。
但本身已經沒有民主派的選委提名，現在民主三百家仲話捆綁投俾民望最高，怕不怕一票民主派都攞唔到？
這個不存在怕不怕的問題，我都會努力做好個工作。
民主派最後一票都不投票給你，其實對於你上任之後有沒有，會不會影響到你收款和民主派之間的關係？
我在政綱裏面都講了，我非常之重視行政立法的關係，一定會是廣開言路，跟立法會不同黨派建立一個上設的溝通的途徑，希望能夠達成廣泛的共識，為香港來到做一些實事。以至在立法會以外，我的管治新風格亦都是包括廣納民意、與民共議，所以希望選舉過之後，下一屆政府透過行政長官的努力，都在這些地方能夠可以做一番實事。
有沒有人用英文的媒體朋友？還有哪一位英文媒體朋友舉手？
To Dr. Wong, would you consider stepping up efforts to push national security laws given that the Hong Kong independence movement has a special mention this morning? And also, since in terms of popularity, it's still going to be a big problem ahead, without the pandemic's vote, do you expect you're going to see a very difficult 5 years ahead if you're elected?
Well, it is a constitutional government, it's constitutional duty of the Hong Kong as our government to enact local legislation to put in place Article 23 in the basic law as far as national security is concerned. I will continue to try my very best, if elected as the chief executive for the next term government, to create the necessary conditions and environment conducive to the enactment of local legislation to protect the nation, the 7.3 million population of Hong Kong. As far as popularity in this particular election, I have said time and again that although this is an election involving the 1,194 election committee members, I will try my very best to explain my policies to the people of Hong Kong in order to get their support and endorsement, and I will continue to do so.